21세기는 정보화의 시대라고 합니다. 또 AI 시대, 인공지능의 시대가 다가오고 있다 이런 이야기도 하죠. 어떻게 보면은 정보화 시대에 인공지능이 점점 발달이 되면은 우리의 삶이 좀 편안해지는 것이 아닌가 이런 긍정적인 측면도 있지만 또 한편으로는 좀 무섭고 두려운 마음이 드는 것도 사실이죠. 우리 인류에 대한 정보 그리고 저 개인에 대한 정보가 컴퓨터에 모두 저장이 되고 또 언젠가는 제가 또 컴퓨터에 의해서 조종이 된다라는 거 별로 그렇게 유쾌한 일은 아니죠. 특히 이 많은 정보들을 훔치고 공격해서 이 지구의 이 사회를 어지럽게 하려는 그런 또 이 공격하는 해커들도 있습니다. 이른바 사이버 테러리스트라고 하는데 그 사이버 테러리스트들이 공격을 못하도록 그리고 소중하고 중요한 정보들을 잘 꽁꽁 감추고 보관하기 위해서 또 노력하는 사람들도 있죠. 이런 일을 하는 분들을 사이버 시큐리티라고 하는데 여러분 전 세계에서 이 사이버 시큐리티의 기술이 가장 뛰어난 나라가 이스라엘이라고 합니다. 이스라엘에서 현재 이 사이버 시큐리티 일을 하고 있는 엘라드 씨가 우리 한국을 방문하셨고 또 저희 브레드 TV 스튜디오도 찾아와 주셨습니다. 오늘 이 엘라드 씨로부터 우리는 지금 어떤 세상에 살고 있으며 이런 정보화 시대에 또 어떤 공격과 방어 이런 일들이 일어나는지 좀 이야기를 자세하게 들어보도록 하겠습니다. 어서 오십시오. 고맙습니다.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. 제가 사이버 시큐리티라고 소개해드렸는데 구체적으로 어떤 일을 하는 겁니까?
Why I basically do, I work in a security operations center is we, in every organization, it's becoming mandatory today because of the situation of cybersecurity that's going, just developing. We sit down and we monitor all of the incoming information and outgoing information from the world into the organization, what's going in and out, basically. Mm-hmm. So we monitor everything that happens, every bit of information that comes in and out, that's what we do. And we analyze exactly what's happening behind those actions. So that's basically the job.
그리고 제가 조금 전에 소개해 드릴 때 전 세계에서 그래도 이 사이버 시큐리티 분야가 이스라엘이 가장 뛰어나다 이렇게 소개를 해 드렸는데 특별히 이스라엘이 이쪽 분야에 기술이 뛰어난 게 된 특별한 이유가 있습니까?
The first reason is because Israel doesn't have a lot of restrictions when it comes to the computer and technology field. When it comes to hacking, there is no really laws that really restrict any, let's say, downloading and doing other stuff. So not like in the States that if you download, you get arrested. In Israel, they allow you to experiment. So that's why I think it's been able to... Also, the Prime Minister, Bibi Netanyahu, said it in Cybertech in 2 years ago. He said, I will not restrict my laws so people can learn how to even attack. You need to learn, in order to defend, you need to know how to attack. So I think that's the main reason why Israelis are very advanced in the field, because they experiment and they try.
엘라드 씨께서 보시기에는 그러면 현재 이스라엘을 향해서 공격해오는 이 주체가 어느 나라가 많습니까?
Most of the attacks come from the Arab countries because they have stated that they will take down Israel. So those are the biggest percentage. Next is China. We know that as a fact because we have statistics. And the next ones are Europe, Africa, Latin America. Those are the next ones. North America is the least because of the laws that they have there. But it's basically the Arab nations and China. Those are the biggest ones.
Israel을 향해서 이 사이버 공격을 하려는 사람들 구체적으로 이스라엘의 어떤 분야로 이 사이버 공격을 해오는 거죠?
Basically, yeah, military is number one target. being targeted by cyber warfare, basically, because Israel is very advanced in developing weapons. So the information is very, very, very important to get. They're trying to get it. The number two is big organizations trying to get data, stealing data, so they could sell it on the black market. And private people, it's a little less, but a lot of private people do get attacked because you can infiltrate an organization through a private person. That's one of the ways to do it. So the smaller people are the last people, but first is military, then is big organizations and government trying to steal data, information, anything that could be sold on the black market, basically.
제가 언젠가 그 이 신문 기사를 읽어보니까 특히 미국같이 인터넷이나 이런 정보와 기술이 발달된 나라일수록 이 사이버 공격을 통해서 미국이라는 나라가 망할 수도 있다 이런 얘기를 하더라고요. 그만큼 미사일이 날아오거나 핵폭탄이 터져서 망하는 것이 아니라 사이버로도 나라가 망할 수도 있다 이런 얘기를 하더라고요. 맞습니까?
That's very true. That's our biggest problem. Technology is our biggest helper and our biggest enemy. That's the biggest thing that is today. We carry around our own privacy killer. We carry around everywhere. It has a camera, it has a microphone. Any program that I could upload to your phone, I could be tracking wherever you go. I could hear your conversations. I could see what you're seeing. I could see the people you're seeing. I could take pictures of you. And I could use all this information against you. Another thing is all of our power supply, water, fresh air in buildings, food. All of the industries are technological based. Agriculture, everything works on computers. So once you get to those sources, you basically take down the whole country. You don't have water, you don't have food, you don't have communications. You can't, army uses GPS. Mainly once you take down GPS systems, the army can't launch rockets. They can't fly planes. They can't do nothing. They're disabled. So yeah, that's very true. Our biggest enemy is the technology, basically. But even though it helps us so much, it still could take us down very easily.
얼마 전에도 뉴스에 그런 게 나왔어요. 그 페이스북이라고 하는 그 SNS가 사용자들의 모든 정보들을 다 취합해서 다른 데 막 넘기고 이런 것 때문에 막 법정까지 가고 이런 일들이 일어났는데 저는 가끔 그런 생각을 해요. 제가 가지고 있는 아이폰이라든가 이 스마트폰 같은 것들이 결국은 이 마지막 때에 우리 인류를 이렇게 막 조종하고 그러는데 SNS라든가 구글이라든가 또는 아이폰 이런 사람들이 큰 역할을 하지 않을까 이런 생각을 해보거든요.
We are giving out today our own personal information voluntarily by uploading our whole life onto social networks. So that's being sold by all the big companies first, all that data to advertisers. That they use our, Facebook knows us better than my brother knows me. Then my father knows me. It has all my information. It knows what I like. It knows what I do. It knows where I go. It knows who I talk to, who's my friends. It knows a lot more than all the rest of the people around me know. Now, Google is one of the biggest. They own all their data centers in the world, and all the information is being stored in those data centers. The biometric system is being fed into those data centers because that's what connects the whole world together. These companies are basically taking over they're holding all the information. They're gathering and they're storing it for themselves, because whoever is going to have the most data is going to be the most powerful. Because once you have data, that data feeds AI, for instance, and it tells it how to act. That's where it learns. And this is a growing trend that people are just feeding their information into the web, and it's just growing and growing. And these companies are getting more and more and more power, and they're just selling it just to make profit, and the governments can't stop it, basically. It's very hard, even though they're suing Facebook right now. Facebook made so much money even before, they don't care being sued. It's a very big problem that it's growing and growing.
어떻게 해야 됩니까? 그러면 나에 대한 것을 누군가가 자세하게 알게 하고 싶지 않고 누군가가 나를 지켜보지 못하게 하고 싶다면 어떻게 해야 됩니까, 우리가?
That's very hard to do, because today you have CCTV, you have the camera on your phone. It's very hard. I can't say get offline.
휴대폰을 꺼놓은 상태면은 상관없지 않을까요?
You would be safer. You actually would be safer if you turn off your phone, if you turn off all your electric devices. But it will be very hard for you to function in the world, because you still need your credit card. You still need to communicate with your family. You have a job. That's what you need to do. If you don't have that, you can't really advance today. What you can do is, the only things you can do is you have appliances, for home appliances, for security, that most people, 98% of people do not use. You do have those. You could try to minimize the information you share online. Don't voluntarily share what you're doing, where you're going, why you're doing it. Try to keep it minimalistic as much as possible. If you can, get off social networks, that helps a lot, because then your information is being less sold on the market. Those are basically the only things you can do, and it's just to keep as much to yourself and in your private life, and always it does cost a little money to keep yourself safer, and I think it's worth it. And people should invest in their own security in order to keep on living safer.
지금 세계는 우리가 눈에 보이지 않아서 그렇지 이런 사이버 전쟁이 계속 일어나고 공격과 방어가 계속 진행되고 있죠.
Always. Cyber warfare is just being elevated every day. We've seen it start in 98 with the first virus worm that was developed. And that was just as a test to see how big the World Wide Web could be. And ever since, vulnerabilities have been taken advantage of, and that people study how to take advantage of these vulnerabilities inside the web. So weapons are being developed to take down infrastructure. We've seen that start. The biggest thing that happened was in 2014, I think, with Iran, with the Natanz facility over there. That almost started the Third World War, when Iran was enriched, or they were at the height of enriching uranium, and all of a sudden there was an attack. Nobody took the responsibility, but you need to understand that facility was not connected to the internet. It is so hard to get a virus in there to start working. It takes a tactical strategy to get in there. So they're, this is the next step of warfare. They don't want to send out soldiers because it takes too many lives. Nobody wants to ship over soldiers. It takes too much fuel. But if you do it through the web, you need just one person. It doesn't take too much. So this is the way they're trying to develop in order to attack. This is going to be the next war, I think.
지금 이런 상황들이 앞으로 점점 더 많이 발달하면서 활발해질 것 같아요. 우리 인류의 삶이 더 평안해질 거라고 보십니까? 아니면 점점 더 힘들어질 거라고 보십니까?
It's very dangerous, but it's in our hands. It's in the humans' hands to see where it's going to go. We can only hope and pray that it will go in a good way. But so far, we're only getting, as we go forward, we're seeing more and more revelations, you could say, come true. We're working on chips today, that we're working on cashless societies. Soon there's going to be the first pilots coming out for cashless societies. And how that's going to work? We already have the chips in the card. Soon it's going to be on us. They're already working on medical chips that could tell your medical state, how you're feeling, if you're happy, if you're sad. And that's being pushed forward. So it really depends on how we move it forward. But from what we know how it's going to go because it says in the Bible.
점점 더 무서워지는 것 같은데 논리적으로 생각하고 과학적으로 생각해야 되는 이 연구원한테 이런 질문을 해도 될지 잘 모르겠지만 어떻습니까? 엘라드 씨께서 보시기에 이런 상황들이 점점 심각해지는 것을 보면서 주님이 다시 오실 때가 다 되었다 이렇게 느끼십니까?
I think so. I really much think so. You could see the advancement. If you read your Bible and you see if you read technology, what's being developed, you could see it's starting to match up slowly, even though the prophets didn't know what a chip was. They didn't know that you could scan. They didn't know that NFC technology. They never heard of that. But you could see things starting to progress according to things that are written.
대략 보도를 통해서는 알고 있었지만 오늘 이렇게 구체적으로 사이버 세상에서 어떤 전쟁이 일어나고 있는지를 이야기를 들어보니까 진짜 더 우리가 좀 각성해서 깨어 있어야 될 때가 아닐까 이렇게 좀 생각이 드는 그런 시간이었습니다. 이스라엘에서 한국까지 멀리 이렇게 찾아오셨는데 오신 목적 잘 달성하기를 바라시고요. 이스라엘의 군인들이 국토를 지키듯이 또 우리 엘라드 씨는 사이버 상에서 공격해오는 많은 적들을 무찌르고 막아내는 방어자로서의 역할을 훌륭하게 잘 감당해 주시길 바라겠습니다. 오늘 이렇게 귀한 시간 내주시고 또 이야기해 주셔서 고맙습니다. Thank you very much.
Thank you.